As you look at Jesus, the high priest, the letter to the Hebrews tells us that he is of the order of Melchizedek. Let's go back to Melchizedek. Where else do we hear this name? In the book of Genesis, he's mentioned, and twice again in the Old Testament, he's spoken of. Who is Melchizedek? Melchizedek is defined or referred to as the priest of God Most High. And what is peculiar about this priest is that he brings out bread and wine. Now, why does Melchizedek bring out bread and wine? Well, the Levitical priesthood, as we know it, when they wanted to offer to God a sacrifice, the sacrifice would be one of blood. Why blood? Why animals? Precisely because it reminded them that their sin caused death. As the Book of Wisdom tells us, death wasn't created by God, but sin brought death into the world. And so every animal sacrifice, the bloodied sacrifice, reminded the person who had sinned of that animal taking his or her place. Melchizedek, on the other hand, is referred to as the priest of God Most High. He is the king of Salem, and he is referred to as the man of righteousness. Such a person, my dear brothers and sisters, does not need to offer the sacrifice of blood. And therefore, what does he offer? He offers bread and wine, symbols of himself. How do we get bread and wine? In fact, at the Mass, when we offer bread and wine, what is it that we say? Fruit of the earth and work of human hands. Exactly what this bread and wine symbolizes. Melchizedek himself. As we fast forward to Jesus, we recognize Jesus doing something very similar. At the Passover, the Last Supper, he takes bread and wine, but then he changes it and says, "This is my body and this is my blood. This is the new covenant in my blood." But wait a minute. Bread and wine are being offered as body and blood. But where is the body and where is the blood? If you look at and study the Old Testament, and if you look and study the Passover, the Last Supper that Jesus celebrates, we'd recognize that Jesus interrupts this Last Supper and goes on to the cross, where he completes this sacrifice, where bread changes to body and wine changes to blood. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, what is Jesus offering? Jesus, like Melchizedek, is offering himself. And when we see what Jesus offers and how he offers himself and how his side is pierced with a lance and at once comes blood and water from his side, we recognize the fulfillment of all prophecies. Jesus, the new temple, blood and water flowing from his side, a fulfillment of the prophecy of Ezekiel. Jesus, my dear brothers and sisters, when he institutes the Last Supper, he institutes two things, the Eucharist and the priesthood. This is my body, this is my blood. But how will this continue down the ages? Because he tells the apostles, the 12, do this in memory of me. And therefore, each time the priest offers the sacrifice of Jesus, but in an unbloodied manner, what does he do? He relives the entire passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus. And this, my dear brothers and sisters, is how the priesthood moves from the Levitical priesthood to the priesthood of Christ. What is important to know is Christ's priesthood, unlike the Levitical priesthood, is a sacrifice of himself. And this in itself is a fulfillment of the prophecy that David sings out in Psalm 51, where this is a great psalm of repentance, where he repents and he recognizes what God really wants. God doesn't want sacrifice. David recognizes his sin and he realizes that sacrifices are not sufficient. What is required? A humble, contrite heart, O Lord, you will not spurn. That humble, contrite heart is what Jesus offers. That perfect obedience to the Father, the perfect giving of himself to the Father. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus not only completes the prophecies of Ezekiel and the other prophets, but in a very special way, he also brings out the great usefulness and the great utility value of the Melchizedek offering, the offering of bread and wine, the offering of himself, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It is the offering that he himself gives of himself. Unlike the Levitical priesthood, which offered something other than oneself, an animal, grain offering, etc., everything was other than the priest. In Jesus, the priest, the altar, and the sacrifice are all one. And this is the new priesthood that moves into the New Testament and into the here and now.